At different stages in our lives, most people have had to deal with their fair share of insecurities. For some, it's their height. For others, it's their skin tone. For many people, it's their dentition, the way their legs look, the way their body looks, because society has decided or defined what they term to be beautiful. And even in this present day and age, for many people, it's weight. The truth is, there's always that one thing or the other that can make you feel less of yourself, but it can't make you feel less of yourself unless you give it that power. Today, we're going to be speaking with a man who is not on the tall side, but has the tallest of dreams, not impeded by his height or the lack of it. He's gone into the political space and is fighting for the rights of people living with dwarfism. Enjoy this package and be inspired. Remember, no one can make you feel inferior without your consent.
My name is Honorable Elder Israel Oludije Akiode Eke Osa, the President Founder of the Dwarf Association of Nigeria, and I'm one of the state school of the party, State Special Fiscally Challenged Leader of APC Lagos State. Firstly, when I joined the politics in 1983, I will be using and dumped. So when they use me, they dump me, they give me money and they go. So by the fortunate thing, in 2007, God answered my prayer. I contested as a councillor. So we throw that thing down to the national leader, Asiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu. So by there now, they say they want to kidnap me. Aregbe Shola was also there. Well, so they say, why should they kidnap me because of contesting for councillorship? They gave me supervisor for fiscally challenged and entertainment in Oshodi Solo local government from 2008 to 2011. After leaving that place, I started looking. So when we did the election in 2011, I went to my national leader again, say, where are they going to give me? Say, don't worry, they will give me another appointment. So far, I should not contest more. So I went to him and then he gave me as senior special assistant to the Commissioner of Transport on Fiscally Challenge. If you see all the we are painted, we are regarded for fiscally people. It's through my inspiration and through his, our collaboration with our excellency by then, Babatunde Raju Fashola, said there must be a law for fiscally challenged. And through me and others, we passed the law that we are using and we are enjoying it now. Likewise, and in if you see many of us now, they are working. You see all the people that we have seven clusters. Yeah, we have seven clusters and this is Office of Disability, Lagos is Office of Disability. We have the blind, we have the physically people, we have the scanned people, we have the albinism, like albino. So we have the syndrome and we have dwarf, we have deaf. All of them now, they ask the government to give us about 1% in employing. And they have started doing since 2012. Our people are working all over the ministries now. All the people are disabilities. So that is part of the vision of democracy. Now, as I'm talking to you presently, I'm one of the state school of the party, State Special Fiscally Challenged Leader of APC Lagos State. And I'm encouraging all of you others, don't ridicule yourself. What the top people can do, short people can do more better, other fiscal challenge can do more better than them. And in disability, there's ability. Don't ridicule yourself. But for me, they don't think say I will be here. At least, as I'm talking to you, I'm head of my Akiwadi family, both in Lagos, Abeokuta, and Nodeda. I'm head of family of Akiwadi. But by then, the things they want to throw me away. They say I'm a strange man or this and that. That is how I am today. I thank God I always qualify God where I am. So in democracy, in party, in politics, I'm enjoying dividend of democracy. I don't see myself as a disabled, but I'm a dwarf. I know that I'm a dwarf, I'm a short man. And fingers are not equal. Those people are tall. I have told you that what tall people can do, short people can do more better. Don't think that they are tall, they can be dwarf or blind or albino or physical or syndrome, they cannot do more better than them. We are better than them. God have everything, as you say, everything that is created he created it very well. They treated me. If I want to tell you a long story, that one day when I was in school, that was 77. So I was coming from school. So my seniors carry a bag. About 3 bags of my seniors, I carry it. That's how I knew, say, tomorrow will be better for me. The governor, the first military governor of Ogun State, was coming from Ibadan. They are going for GOC meetings. That is General Seju Ayodele Balogun, the first military governor of Ogun State, 1976. That one was 1977. So he saw me just fat. Ah, he said, why people carry bag on my head like this? So he turned back. He went straight to the principal. Our principal by then, Mr. Amuzovi, is late now. He went to them and said, why are you punishing this man? Who put all this bag on his head? He said, it's, you know, because all their names are inside the bags. So he's going to call them. And from then, he told my principal that this is the son of governor. So anything they do to me, he gave me to say, card. So I should come to governor's of that, okay, my son, by then. So, and I was served free privilege. Since I finished my secondary school, nobody worried me, nobody troubled me. Some of you, our governor, Mr. Babajide Olusola, someone is going to empower us this year again. You have some little amount. So I had to empower all the tables, all the 7 clusters. When I want to marry my wife, the family rejected me. They said that you are, you know, sit out of people to marry. Why are you going to marry this church man? He said, this man, I love him. And I'm married, that's how we finish. Only one person that supported me by that time say, if you want Leo, that is their life, let them go and pray. And since then, we are together. And those people that hate us now, they are coming to us saying, Baba, forgive us. So that is it. So nobody don't have enemy. Even though you are tall, the family will reject you. The advice I'm going to give to people with disability that are all the 7 cross-sized, they should encourage themselves in their ability, in disability, their abilities. They should not think that because there's a disability, they should turn to beggar. Most of our blind people and those of our physically people, they should not turn themselves to, they should go one way or another to go for vocational study. They should go and do it. They learn one or two things. A blind, if you go to federal school of blind, you should. They are doing basket there. So if you go there, if you go to Ojo Ogoloto, they are training them there. Likewise, yeah, I will encourage them that you should go and do land, like one or two things. Like shoemaking, like barbing, like whatever they want, like hairdressing. Not that because you have disability, you turn yourself to ability to yourself. No, it's not good. Let them people support, let them move on. From there, people will support you. I have one man that even though I'm bringing this year. He's doing traffic at General Hospital on that bridge. It's a physical challenge. He's using this thing they are using. And he's passing well. I want to encourage him. Anytime they want to do the day of physical challenge, I will call the governor, will assist him. You empower him. That is it. I'm encouraging them. They should not use themselves as because they have one way or other disabilities and turn it to useless sometimes. So I don't support that.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.